In this video, I'm going to share with you inside the new Canva AI features. I am so excited, you guys. If you've been following our channel for any period of time, you know that I love Canva. Canva is one of the best tools available, especially if you're a real estate professional. And holy moly, there are so many awesome new AI tools available. So in this video, I'm going to walk you through some of the best AI tools for real estate agents. I'm going to walk you step by step how to use them, and I'm going to show you which ones are my favorites and which ones I encourage you to use. Before we jump into those tools, by the way, I would absolutely love if you hit the subscribe button and the bell button. We have new videos like this that come out each and every week. All right, let's get into Canva and AI. So we are here in Canva. Let's talk about some of the cool things that you can do when it comes to AI, especially for real estate. All right, so we're on canva.com, and I might have mentioned this before, but I love designing on Canva on my computer. You can also do it on your mobile device, but for the sake of this video and this example, we're going to use the desktop version of Canva. So we're on canva.com, and on the left hand side, I'm going to draw your attention to this section called apps. If you click on apps, there's all kinds of fun things that you can really explore. Some of these things you might be familiar with, some of these things you may not be familiar with, but there's lots of things that are available right within Canva besides just creating graphics and social media posts and flyers and things like that. So the first thing I want to point out, especially with our conversation with AI, is this button right here that says text to image. So this is featured right under trending and other new. If you don't see that, you can just go into search apps and search text to image, and you're looking for this little purple icon right here. So I'm going to click on text to image, and it's going to ask me if I want to use it in an existing design or use it in a new design. So we're going to click use new design, and it's going to say, well, what do you want to design? So let's type in Instagram and see what comes up. And we're gonna design an Instagram square post, which, by the way, I love to design in that Instagram square size. I feel like it's universal for just about any platform. Okay, so we've got that blank blank canvas here on the screen. If you look to the left, it says text to image. And so we can type in here anything that we're looking for. So let's say you are a real estate agent in maybe Long Beach, California. So you want to have a image of a maybe a beach scene in Long Beach, California. So let's put create an image of Long Beach, California with a beautiful sunset. Okay, so let's see what happens. It's gonna take a second, and you could put anything in here. You could put, you know, create a picture of, you know, the mountains, or, you know, if you're in Lake Tahoe or New York City or whatever your specific area is. I find that this works really well for location specific content. So if you're a real estate agent and you're trying to create a lot of content in Canva, specifically around your local area, I love the text to image that comes up. So you can see we've got some great graphics right here, and we could pick from any one of these. I think they're all beautiful. So I'm just going to pick this one right here, and you're just going to click on it. So I clicked on it, and then I can move it around. I can enlarge it. And then from here, I can create some sort of graphic. So, you know, maybe if you are a realtor in Long Beach, California, every Tuesday you want to do a Tip Tuesday. So you could easily take this. I could add a little bit of text. I'm just going to click this text button right here. I'm going to add a text box. I'm going to make this bigger. And then in that text box, maybe I just write something like Tip Tuesday. I can type it here. There we go. And let's make that a little bit bigger like that. And now we've created kind of a really simple, easy graphic. And of course, if I wanted to, I could add a couple things. I could enhance this a little bit. I'm going to click effects. I'm going to click this lift button to kind of make that pop just a little bit. And I might even add the city, which I think is really kind of nice if you're creating graphics for your specific city. So let's add another text box, and maybe we'll put this in kind of a cursive font. And we will put in here Long Beach, California. And I'm gonna make that white, and we're gonna make that a little bit bigger also. So let's make that a little bit larger, make sure we capitalize the L there. And there we go. And so now we've used something like AI to create a graphic that's completely unique. You're not gonna see that graphic anywhere else. And now we can take this, we could download this, put this into Instagram, Facebook, LinkedIn, and then you could write a tip of the week, right? Some sort of tip about what you love about living in Long Beach, or tips for relocating to Long Beach, or tips for moving, or anything like that. So again, quickly and easily, we were able to create a graphic, which is great. You can also click animate. so I could click animate if I wanted to animate this graphic and make it a little bit, you know, more of kind of a video, so to speak. And by the way, I'm going to name that because it just says your paragraph text. So let's name that here in Canva. There we go. Let's name that Tip Tuesday. And I'm just going to go back home. And again, just to show you again really quick, if you go under apps, I'm going to click apps one more time, go down to trending. Again, this is what appears for me, text image. If you don't see that, you can just search that right here. So if you wanted to kind of start over, if you wanted to use it in an existing design, for example, if we wanted to take that design we just created, we could click use that existing design. So let's start it over in a new design. Let's click use new design and we're going to click Instagram. Post in a square. Let's do that. And it's going to come up. Now, one thing I will say is text image is still in beta, so it's a little wonky. It may not be completely perfect, but again, we could start all over right here. So again, if we wanted a sunset beach picture of, and we'll say maybe New York City. And maybe it's not a beach picture. Maybe it's just a sunset picture of New York City. And let's see what happens, right? It's going to take a second. It's going to use its AI magic and see what it comes up with. And so again, we've got some really beautiful options here, which is great. Now, by the way, if you don't like the options, there's a button at the bottom that says create again, right? But if I wanted to use any one of these, I could do this. I could just, again, enlarge it. And I just really love the vibrancy of the pictures I've seen so far out of AI. Again, it's in beta, so it's not perfect. But again, I think as an agent, this is a great way to create unique graphics because let's be honest, a lot of times there's like this sea of sameness. A lot of agents will use kind of the same Canva templates. So what a great way to just kind of stand out, use that text to image. Again, keep it simple, less is more. You don't need a whole lot of text over your images. You could actually create a series of images. If you are a broker in New York, you could use all of these images if you'd like. So, you know, what's nice is when you do the text to image, they all kind of match in a lot of ways. So these all kind of work together almost as a series, which is kind of cool. So that's the first tool that I love with Canva, that text to image. Okay, let's go into a few other AI tools that I love with Canva. Okay, so we're gonna go back to my homepage here. And when I go back to my homepage, I'm going to open up a new design. We're gonna click create new design. I'm gonna click Instagram square again because that's my favorite size when it comes to social media posts. And I'm gonna go over to my uploads and I'm going to find a picture, one of my uploaded pictures. Let's click this one right here. And let's make this a little bit larger right here. And what's really kind of cool, two of my favorite AI features that Canva has recently integrated, if I click on the picture right here and I click edit photo, there's actually a couple that come up. So there's Magic Eraser and Magic Edit, which is actually really cool. So with Magic Eraser, I could click on that and it's gonna ask me for the brush size. So I can make the brush size be whatever size I want it to be. You can see it increase there in the middle of the screen. So maybe I have this image from, you know, perhaps a client and I want to erase something. Maybe I don't want those little deers on the walls. So let's take our magic eraser and we're gonna just kind of circle right around those little deer and let's see what happens. It's gonna take a second and it erases it. Now there's a little bit of a dot left. Let's go ahead and click over that and it's going to, through the magic of technology, watch this. Erase it. And then we can do the same thing on this one. Let's do that. Gonna take a second. And there we go, right? So really cool. For those of you who've been in real estate a long time, you know that this type of editing usually is something that you would have to outsource, or if you knew Photoshop, it's something that you would have to do, do with Photoshop. So really cool that you could do that all within Canva, Canva's AI tool using Magic Eraser. Now, if you wanted to reset that, you could click reset and then that would reset that and bring those right back. The other AI tool that I love, if I click edit photo, I'm gonna go back to edit photo and there's also a button called Magic Edit. So we could erase something from a photo, but we could also click Magic Edit. And when I click on Magic Edit, it's gonna say a couple things. So it's gonna say brush over the image, the highlights where the image is going to be edited. Then we're going to describe what to generate and select a result. Okay, so let's say, for example, instead of just erasing these little deer on the wall, we wanted to replace them. So I'm going to highlight this little deer on the wall here, and we're going to hit continue, and it's going to say, what would you like us to replace it with? So let's replace with a wall sconce. Okay. And then let's hit generate and see what happens. And dun, 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 dun. Okay. So there we have a pretty nice looking little wall sconce right there, right? So let's click that. Let's click done, which I love. And now it's brought us back to our main image. Now, as you can see, I actually have two deer, or I had two deer on that picture. So the only bug with the AI is you can't necessarily erase both things and then replace them with the same thing. So we're just going to move this picture over and move that little deer out of the way. Okay, because ultimately what you're only going to see in the picture is one of those little sconces. So there you go, right? Really easy to do. Now, of course, if I really wanted to, I could double click on it and I could go back to edit one more time. And I could, of course, do a couple other things. I could go in and actually erase that if I really wanted to. But again, time is money. Let's keep it simple. We're just going to erase that one and we're just going to kind of move it over right there. And then we're good to go, right? So those three things are probably my favorite AI tools for real estate, right? There was the text to image, which again, I absolutely love for especially any kind of geographic content that you're creating. I also particularly love the magic edit and the magic erase. I think if you've got any kind of images and you want to clean those up. Now, of course, keep in mind, if you're doing this for any real estate photos, we don't want to erase things that are really there in real life, right? For example, if there are power lines over your client's house, we don't want to erase the power lines because that's false advertising, right? But maybe you took a picture of, you know, your client's home and you missed that there was a Kleenex box on the counter, or you missed that there was a towel on the bathroom floor or something like that. This is a really easy way to clean up those sort of maybe mistakes or things we don't want in our final image quickly and easily. So there's other AI tools available in Canva, but again, I just wanted to focus on my top three, and I would love to hear from you. What do you think? So let me know in the comments below. Well, there you go. Those are some of my favorite AI tools. I would love to hear from you. Which one of those AI tools is your favorite? Which is the one you're most excited to use? Let me know in the comments below. As we mentioned, if this was helpful, we would love if you'd hit the subscribe button and the bell button, as we have new videos that come out each and every week. And last but not least, if you're thinking, I gotta get a handle on my Canva and my Canva training, we would love for you to download our free Canva checklist. Go to katielance.com/Canva, get it download, and we'll see you there. Bye for now.